We'll begin with really the primary bhakti practice, which is mantra and chanting. Okay? And honestly, don't worry if you are pronouncing these words wrong. I want you to think about making a joyful noise, of using the mantra. Mantra is mind training or mind tool. So we use the tool of the mantra, of the sound, to quiet the mind. Normally the mind is just incessantly chattering and thinking, all so busy like a monkey. But we use the mantra to have this one repetitive word, phrase, sound to keep the mind returning to presence, to keep the mind, if you will, returning to God. And if the God word doesn't work for you, you pick one that does. But returning to that fullness, completeness, it, love, nature, whatever it is. So you can find a comfortable seat. Sit up nice and tall. Take a deep breath in and a full breath out. Again, deep breath in and a full breath out. The mantra is simple. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Got it? Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. So I'll sing the first line and you, if you dare, call it back, okay? Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Together. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. My turn. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. 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 Ram, 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 Ram. Ram, 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 Ram. Ram 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 Ram. On a hum. Bringing your hands to prayer at the heart. Take a deep breath in. Very soft bow of the head. I pray for all of those beings who have come before us. I pray for all of us who remain, and for those of us who have yet to arrive here on this earth. And today I consider one being in my life who I love so dearly, and I dedicate my practice fully and completely to them, as if I take this effort and I take this breath and I place it at their feet as a sign of my love and my devotion. So hold one being in your heart today, and let's offer it all away. Lift your head and release the hands. Okay, shall we begin a little bit of movement? It might be a strong practice, so I encourage you to modify. If you need to, slow down, take rest as you need, okay? We'll begin in Supta Baddha Konasana. This is laying on your back, the knees bent, and the soles of the feet together. And just place one hand over your heart and the other hand over your low belly. Okay, and you just take 5 or 7 breaths here. Breathing through the nose, inhaling, and through the nose, exhaling. Through the nose, inhaling, and through the nose, exhaling. Feel yourself rooting into the ground. Feel yourself opening the body, but also opening the heart, opening the mind. Receptive, like a cup waiting to be filled. Just a couple more breaths. A deep breath in. And a full breath out. Bring your hands outside the thighs. Draw the knees to your chest. Give yourself a squeeze. And lower the knees to the right. And look to your left. Just 2 breaths here, a little gentle twist. Wide awake, wide awake. Come back to your center, change. Knees to the left. Your hips to the right. Gaze over your right shoulder. Come back to center. Hey, how about happy baby? Take a hold of the sides of your feet or your big toes. Pull the knees wide. It can be a deep pose this early on, but just see how it feels. You can always take your hands to your shins, your ankles. Breathe for 3. Can you make circles with your ankles? Point and flex the toes. 2. 1 more breath here. Good. Knees to your chest. Hands to the shins and just a gentle rocking along the spine. Just a massage for the whole back. Be really careful here with your cervical spine up into your neck. And then next time when you rock forward, I want you to find that balancing point on your sitting bones. So the toes are off the earth, arms forward. You can stay here or reach the legs forward. We'll be here for about an hour, so just get used to it. No, 7. Spread the toes, 6. This is Navasana boat pose. 5, 4, get long through the spine. 3, 2, and knees to your chest, rock all the way back. And then a couple times again, rock forward and back, and then we'll rock all the way up to standing into our forward fold. Uttanasana, bend the knees, take a hold of your ankles. And bend one knee and then the other. Pulling out the legs, release the weight of the head. Go brrr. Relax the face and the eyes. Release the hands, clasp them behind your back. Squeeze the palms together and lengthen the knuckles towards the front of your mat. So the belly, if possible, is on your chest. That's not possible. The belly cannot be on the chest. Your belly is on your thighs.
Two more breaths. Breathing through the nose, inhaling.
Through the nose, exhaling.
One more big breath.
Slowly release. Bend the knees round all the way up to stand. The head and neck come up last. Reach the arms over the head. Inhale. Hands to your heart. Exhale. Release the hands. Keep exhaling. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands through the heart. Empty all the way out. Use the full duration of the breath. Just moving breath and movement. Inhale, reach up. Exhale. Try that three more times on your own. Inhale. And exhale. Again, inhale, and exhale, good, arms up, from the hips hinge, fold forward, touch the earth, you can bend the knees here as much as you need, inhale, look forward, long spine, exhale, deepen your fold, round all the way up to stand, vertebra by vertebra. The head and neck come up last. Arms reach overhead. And then exhale, immediately fold forward again. Touch the earth. Bend the knees as much as you need. Inhale, look forward, long spine. Deepen your fold, exhale. Bend the knees round all the way up to stand. Feeling the breath move, arms up. Exhale, fold forward, last time like this. Inhale, lengthen your spine and step back to plank pose, so the top of a push-up. And if you need to, you can lower your knees here, but look at your hands. Spread the fingers wide and then dial the inner elbows, the inner arms forward. Pull the low belly in, push the heels back, heart forward. So you're really strong here. Breathe for five, push the earth away. Good, four, nice strong back, three. Last two, with absolute control, can you lower to the earth? Good. Untuck the toes. Just a little baby cobra. Widen through the collarbones. Exhale, release forehead to the earth. Two more. Inhale, lift up a little bit higher, perhaps. Exhale, release. One more time. Nice tall cobra. Sometimes I'll slide my hands forward a little bit. Shoulders back and down. Good. Release. Child's pose, balasana. The knees wide, the hips back. Just take one breath here. And you can come here at any time throughout practice for any reason, okay? You don't need permission. Rise to all fours. Exhale, round the spine. Dome the upper back. Inhale, drop the belly. Cow pose. And exhale, round the spine, cat, and go, meow. Drop the belly, you go, moo. Exhale, round the spine, curling. One more, inhale, drop your belly. Stretch the throat even, exhale, round. Come back to neutral. Bring your left toes to the back of the mat. And then just a little bit of forward and back motion as you stretch through the foot and stretch through the belly of the calf muscle and the thigh. So look, my belly can hang out here and my low back kind of collapses, or I can tone my abdomen and get really strong. Try that. Pause in the center. Pivot your left heel down and let your right ankle come out to the right, left arm up. So this is a variation of side plank. And take a few big circles with your arm. So we start slow in the beginning, and then we'll pick up, we'll get into a rhythm, maybe a little sweat. Cool. And then change directions with that arm. Nice slow circles. Good. Left arm up. Stay here, two more breaths, or just lift your right leg off the earth for three. Push into that right hand strong. Two. One more big breath. Right knee down. Left hand down. Left knee down. Back to neutral, all fours. Exhale, round the spine. Inhale, drop the belly, lift the heart, look up. And exhale, round. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Come back to neutral. Your right toes to the back of the mat. And then again, just stretch the belly of the calf, the thigh, the arch of the foot, the toes. And your gaze is just slightly forward. Gentle rocking. Good. Pause here. Pivot your right heel down. The left leg opens to the left, right arm up. Side plank variation. Vashisthasana. And then take some big circles with that right arm. Start with one direction. Breath is steady through the nose. Change directions. Keep that left arm like a pillar, so strong and straight. The fingers spread wide, and the fingers almost like suction cups, gripping. Good, right arm up. Stay here, three breaths, or lift your left knee up. Three. Up, up, up. Two. That's it. One more big breath. Knee down. Right hand down. Right knee down. Child's pose. Hips back. Like a snake, slide forward to a cobra. Inhale. Child's pose. Exhale. Two more of those. Stay really low. Inhale. Really low. Exhale, child's pose. Belly back, hips back. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Rise to all fours. Hands and knees. Tuck your toes under. Lift your knees. Downward facing dog. For a moment, pedal out your legs. Bend one knee and then the other. Encouraging the heels slowly deeper and deeper to the mat. Perhaps eventually both heels can come down. Look to your hands. Fingers are spread wide. Hands about shoulder width apart a little more. Look to your feet. Feet are hip width apart. The sides of the feet parallel with the sides of the mat. Cool. Rise to your toes. Bend the knees. Look forward. Softly. Step, jump, or float to the top. Beautiful. Inhale. Lengthen your spine. Exhale. Deepen your fold. Bend the knees, round up to stand. The head and neck come up last. Arms up, inhale. Hands to the heart, eyes open. Exhale, release the hands. So we'll do a couple of salutations with low lunges. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bow forward, hinging from the hips. One breath, one movement now. Inhale, look forward. Step your right foot back, lower the right knee. Sweep the arms up. One breath here. Hands to the heart, to the earth. Downward facing dog. Step back. This is the pace. Inhale, plank pose. Exhale, you can lower half or all the way to the earth. Cobra pose or upward facing dog. Exhale back, downward facing dog. You doing okay? Reach your right leg up. Inhale. Step your right foot forward. Exhale. Easy twist. Reach your right arm up. Inhale. Right hand down. Straighten your right leg. Exhale. Good. Rebend your knee. Step the left foot forward. Inhale. Look forward. Exhale. Deepen your fold. Root to rise. Stand up. Reach up. Look up. Maybe a little back bend at the top. Hands to the heart. Eyes open. Exhale. Release your hand. Inhale. Sweep up. Exhale, bow forward, touchdown. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Step your left foot back, lower the left knee. One breath now, arms up. Pull the belly off that right thigh. Hands through the heart, to the earth. Downward facing dog, step back. Inhale, plank pose, rock forward. Chaturanga, lower half or all the way. Upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale back, down dog. You're doing great. Reach your left leg up. Softly step your left foot forward. Easy twist, left arm up, inhale. Exhale, left hand down, straighten your left leg. Ah. Bend the left knee, step forward. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, deepen your fold. Inhale, rise, stand up, reach up, look up. Hands to the heart, exhale. Utkatasana, bend the knees, sink the hips, touch the earth out in front of you. That's how low the hips are. Arms up. Then we add just a little bit of a, just a little dance, just for a second, just a little booty sway. Come on, let your hips sway. If your yoga is rigid, you're not doing yoga. You're doing something else. Come on. Can you get your hands? One more big breath. All right, stand up, take a back bend, open up. Exhale, fold forward. Hands touch the earth. Inhale, halfway lift. You can either step back or jump back and lower with control. Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Bhujangasana. Exhale, press back, Adho Mukha, downward facing dog. Reach your right leg up. Bend your knee, open your hip. Lift the knee way up as you encourage the left heel down. Good. Right knee to your right elbow. Rock forward. Beautiful. Tap. Three-legged dog. Inhale. Knee to your nose. Exhale. Curling. Chinning. Bellying. Three-legged dog. Right leg up. Right knee to your left elbow. Tap. Perfect. Three-legged dog. Warrior one. Step your right foot forward. Pivot your left heel down. Arms up. Good. If you want, palms together and look up. Lift the heart. Pull the low belly in. Wake up that back leg. Steady the eyes for three. Lengthen the arms even more. Two. One more big breath. Hands to your heart. Lace the fingers behind the back. And then look at your right foot. Can you walk it to the right a little bit? Stretch the knuckles back. Lift the chest. Inhale. Then exhale, fold. Let your right shoulder rest on the thigh. You can stay here or bypass the thigh. Put your head on the earth or close to the earth. Hug the right hip in and back. Through the nose, inhaling. Through the nose, exhaling. Through the nose, inhaling. And through the nose, exhaling. One more time. Look forward. Hands down. Step back, plank. Top of a push-up. One inhale. Chaturanga. Exhale. Up dog or cobra, stretch. Beautiful. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Reach your left leg up. Bend your knee, open your hip. My teacher always said, happy hips, happy life. Left knee, left elbow. Curl and tap. That's it. Three-legged dog. Inhale. Knee to nose. Exhale. Three-legged dog. Left knee, right elbow. Three-legged dog. Softly step the left foot forward, pivot your right heel down, warrior one, arms up. The palms can be together or not. So you're trying to wrap that back hip forward. It won't square off, but that's the movement, that's the motion. Right hip forward, left hip back. Arms up. Sink deep into it, strong, wide awake. And let this be your offering. You step into the fire, you step into effort for the one you love. Breathe for three, maybe a little smile on your face, nothing crazy, just a small one. Smile of contentment. One more big breath here. Hands to the heart. Behind the back, clasp the hands, but walk over one finger, so it feels a little strange. Walk your left foot over to the left, lift your chest, take a little back bend, wrench knuckles down, exhale, fold. humble warrior. Again, you can let your left shoulder, chest, rest on the thigh. We'll go a little deeper. Five, four. Breathe for three. Can you put your head on the earth? It's so close. Two. Come on. One more big breath. Good. Look forward. Hands down. Step back. Plank. Inhale. Chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Exhale back. Downward facing dog. Good. Walk your hands to your feet. Back of the mat. Take your feet apart 8 or 10 inches. Grip your big toes. Peace sign fingers. Look forward. Exhale, bow forward. You can bend the knees as much as you need. Pull up on the big toes. And the big toes push down on the fingers so they're resistant. And start to bend the knees a little bit. And then try to straighten them. Bend the knees a little bit. And then try to straighten them. So think tailbone, sitting bones up. I'm trying to lengthen the sitting bones up. One more big breath. Look forward. Release your grip. Downward facing dog. Walk it out. Good. Bring your feet together, please. Rock forward, plank. Right hand, center of the mat. Side plank. Again, you can lower the right knee or both legs are straight. Left arm up or reach forward. You can modify this however you'd like. Push into the earth. Good. Lift your right hip up into the left hip. Big stretch for that left side body for three. Open, open. Open the body to open your heart. Two. One more big breath. Plank pose. Come on back. Either five breaths in plank or five slow push-ups. You can lower the knees too if you want. That's it. Oh, those are really slow. I love that. One more time. Downward facing dog. Walk the hands to your feet. Back of the mat again. And now we go a little deeper. Padahastasana. Palms underneath the feet. Yeah? So your padas, that's foot, are on your hastas, hands. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, deepen your fold. Can you flutter your lips? Like you're cold. And release any unnecessary tension in the mouth, in the tongue. One more big breath. Look forward. Release the grip. Take your dog for a walk. Downward facing dog. Once again, your feet together. Plank pose, left hand, center of the mat, a little forward of the shoulder, stack the heels, right arm up. And again, feel free to lower your left knee. Reach your right arm up and over. Five. Fingertips are like suction cups, so they grip in towards the palm. Three. Stay with it. Two. One more big breath. Come on back, plank pose. Doing great. Forearm plank, lower down to the elbows. In the seesaw motion, forward and back, like you're sawing. Keep the belly drawing in, pushing toes to balls of feet. Gaze forward, 10. Do you feel anything? Anything? If you don't feel anything, lift your feet. 5. Come on now. 4.5. 4. 3.5. It's a really slow count, huh? 3. 2.5. 2. Stay with it. One more big breath. Pause in the center. Lower all the way down. Palms face down. Sphinx pose. Palms down. Hips are down. Toes are untucked. And we're energetically dragging our heart forward. Good. Try this. Elbows in a little bit. Inhale, look up. Then exhale, chin in, curl in, lift everything except the tops of the feet. The tops of the feet are on the ground. Good. Lower the hips, lift the heart. Inhale. Exhale, round in. So think cat-cow. Good. Inhale, keep going. And exhale, lift everything up. Five more on your own. Let your breath guide you. Two more times. Good, come back to neutral. Hands underneath the shoulders. Tuck your toes, lift your knees. Inhale, plank pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful, y'all. Take a deep breath in. Open your mouth, sigh. Reach your right leg up. Bring your right knee to your left elbow. Pivot the back heel down. And then extend your right leg towards the upper left corner of your mat. Yeah? Left arm up. You can stay here, reach the left arm over. You can stay here, or you can lift your right leg up. Maybe you hold the foot, maybe you don't. Lots of options. Three. Yeah, you're so strong. Two. One more big breath. Okay, we're gonna transition to flip dog, wild thing. Left hand down, right knee to your chest, and then roll over. You're now on the pinky toe side edge of your left foot. The right foot's behind you, right arm over. Hips up. How's that going? If this doesn't feel good, you're in down dog, right leg to the sky. For three. Lift a little higher, two. One more big breath. Down dog, right leg up. Inhale. Step your right foot forward. Exhale, high lunge. Reach your arms up. Cactus the elbows, exhale. Good, inhale, reach up. Now we cactus again, but we also bend the left knee 2 inches from the earth. Inhale, reach up, straighten. Exhale, cactus and bend. Two more. Build heat here. One more time. Exhale. Good. Inhale. Reach up. Straighten the back leg. Hands to your heart. Stand up. Left knee to your chest. Yeah. Don't fall over. Open your hip. Tree pose. Left foot to the upper inner right thigh. Steady the eyes. Find your Drishti, this is the gazing point. Stay here, reach the arms up. Tailbone down, core engaged. You can stay here, if this is just so easy for you, close your eyes. Really tall, five. Are you awake, are you alert, are you completely here? Three. Get even taller, two. One more big breath. Hands to your heart. Guide the left knee out in front of you. How about a little bonus? Reach the left leg forward. If you have a banister, you can rest it there, but if you don't have a banister, you have to hover it. Sorry, it's what I have. Use the tools at your disposal. For three, you could use a dog, a tall dog, or a small child. You could put it on the shoulder. One more big breath. Rebend your knee. Warrior three, hinge forward. Pull the belly in, extend the left leg back. Good. You can always take your hands down if you need, all right? Five. Beautiful. Four. Lift your heart a little bit. Good. Three. Beautiful cat. Two. One more big breath. High lunge. Step back. Arms up. Warrior two. Open up. There we go. As you inhale, straighten your front leg, both arms up. Exhale, warrior two, sink deeper. Two more, inhale, stretch, reach. Exhale, warrior two. One more time, inhale. Exhale, stay here. Flip your right hand, reverse warrior. Keep bending the right knee. Stay for the exhale. And say, Good, back to warrior two. Side angle pose, elbow, thigh. Left arm diagonal. And can you tune in? Can you become aware of this one line of energy from left heel to left fingertips? Stretch through that. And then spiral the heart open. You can stay here
You can take a half bind, a full bind, or bird of paradise. Say you have 5 breaths. So naturally, as you stretch, these front ribs start to jut out. Think, draw these low ribs in towards your pelvis. So the core is really strong right here. 2 more big breaths, right in it. I love this. 1 more big breath. If you're bound, release. Warrior 2, rise back up. Straighten your right leg. If you need to, shorten your stance a couple inches. Triangle pose. Reach forward like you're reaching for something far away. Right hand to block, earth, or shin. Left arm up. This is Uttita Chakonasana, an extended triangle yoga pose. Really expand in every single direction here. Cool? Breathe deeply, breathe completely. Don't hold back. Open even more. Open yourself fully. Open yourself to love. Open yourself to the one. 1 more big breath here. Good. Come all the way back up. Warrior 2. Straighten the right leg. Parallel the feet. So turn the right toes in. You might need to adjust your stance. Hands to your hips. Inhale. Lift your heart. With a very fat back, fold forward. Now the hands can stay on the hips or take the hands to the outer heels. Gently pull the chest towards the legs. You can bend the knees here if you'd like. And I like to just do a little bit of gentle rocking side to side in the pelvis. See what feels good for you here. For 3. Trust the body, trust the process. Wide awake and letting go. Take 1 more big breath here. Hands underneath the face. Walk the hands to the front of the mat. Turn all 10 toes forward. Step back plank pose. On a really slow count of 5, lower to your belly. 5. Slow. 4. 3. 2. Don't you dare touch. Mala. Arms alongside the body, chin or forehead to center. Let your hips sway a little bit. Inhale deeply. And then open your mouth, sigh. All right, let's strengthen the back body. Behind the back, interlace your fingers. Knuckles reach back. Shoulder blades draw together. Exhale. And then inhale, lift your chest and lift your legs. This is a variation of locust pose. Tuck your chin in. Jalandhara Bund. Lift the inner legs a little higher. 3. Squeeze those back muscles. 2. 1 more big breath. And release. Left ear on the mat. Let your hips sway side to side. And go, ha. Heels to your butt. Reach back if you're able. Take a hold of the feet or the ankles. You can also just pretend. Are you ready? Are you really ready? Exhale first, empty your breath. And then inhale, kick the feet into the hands. That's it. Good. 5. 4. Gaze stay slightly down. Let the legs do the work. 3. Perfect. Knees in close. 2. 1 more big breath. And with total control, release all the way down. The exit is sacred, so don't miss that. Windshield wiper the knees side to side. Child's pose, hips to your heels. Just 1 breath. Rise to all 4s, round the spine, exhale cat pose. Inhale, arc the spine, look up, cow. Exhale, round. 1 more time. Inhale. And exhale. Back to neutral. Downward facing dog. Tuck your toes. Lift your knees. Okay, we're almost done with the standing stuff. Let's try the, well, all we just did on the second side. Reach your left leg up and back.
Bend your knee, open your hip. Left knee to your right upper arm, ball in triangle. Pivot the right heel down, reach the left leg to the upper right corner of your mat. Open up for three. Breathe for two. Find something new, explore the body. One more big breath. Right hand down, left knee to your chest. Flip all the way over, wild thing. Left foot behind the right leg. And an arc over. And say, For three. Two. One more big breath. Slowly come back, downward facing dog. Left leg to the sky. High lunge. Softly. Step the left. Arms up. I'm facing the back of my mat, but you're facing the front of your mat. Inhale. Practice the elbows. Lift the heart. Exhale. Inhale, reach up. Now we add the bend of the leg. Exhale, cactus and bend. Two more like that. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Straighten the back leg. Arms up. Hands to your heart. Stand up. Right knee to your chest. Lift it up. Open your hip. Vrikshasana tree. Right foot to the upper inner left thigh. And you can go below the knee if you need to. And then maybe arms up. Push the left thigh into the right foot. Get tall. Five. Ribs in, tailbone down. Four. Get really strong. Three. The whole face, the jaw, the tongue is really relaxed. So we try to avoid unnecessary tension in the body. The mind can stay easy. The body might be working, but everything else is so relaxed. Effortless effort. Hands to the heart. Here's your bonus. Right knee out in front of you, and then reach it forward for five. Oh, how convenient. Four, three, two, warrior three. Bend your knee, hinge forward, right leg back, chest forward. The hands can be at your heart, or they can be forward or back. Om five, four. You're like a T-shape. Three, breathe two. Slowly step back, high run. Arms up. Inhale. Warrior two. Exhale. There it is. Cool. Inhale, straighten the front leg, both arms up. Exhale, warrior two. Two more like that. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Pause. Flip your left hand. Reverse warrior. Keep bending your left knee. Really stretch that left side body. Warrior two. Side angle pose. Elbow, thigh, right arm, over. Spiral the torso towards the ceiling. And you lock your eyes on one fixed, non-moving point. You can take your bind. You can take your bird of paradise. Think left thigh bone down and in towards your body. Two more breath. One more big breath. Stay with it. If you're bound, release. Warrior two. Rise up. Straighten your left leg. Triangle pose. Micro bend that left knee. Reach forward, forward, forward. And then down. Can you look up? What do you see up there? I honestly see three cobwebs. Do you see the sky? Do you see the ceiling? See a little chip of paint where you can lock your eyes? Stay with it. Get even longer. Open yourself completely. Do not hold back. Two more breaths. Good. Root to rise. Warrior two. Straighten the left leg. Parallel the feet. Turn your toes in. Behind the back, interlace your fingers. Maybe you're gonna take the feet a little wider. So you're facing the long right edge of your mat, yes? Inhale, lift up. And exhale, fold forward.
5 breaths right here. Prasarita Padottanasana variation B, I think. One more big breath here. Good. Slowly hands to the earth. And then bring both hands over to your left ankle. And just gently pull the heart, pull the torso towards your left leg. And then change. Both hands over to the right. Release. Hands to the front of the mat. Step back, downward facing dog. Inhale, plank pose. Exhale slowly to your belly. 5, 4, 3, 2.5, 2. We're still on 2, you, and touchdown. Oh, heels to your butt. This time, can you turn your hands around so you hold the inner arches of the foot? Yeah, so your hands are flipped. Another way is you can cross your wrists, not the ankles, but the wrists. Chin or forehead to center. Just try it. Exhale first, prepare. Inhale, kick up. It might not go as far. Just see how it feels. 5. Beautiful. Gaze down. 4. 3. Last 2. And with absolute control, release. Windshield wiper knees side to side. And go, ha. Send the hips back. Let your forehead rest. If your forehead's sweaty, you can wipe the sweat off with your mat. It's a nice little trick. Walk both hands over to the left. And reach the right hand a little further. Good. Hands over to the right. Just 2 breaths. Back to center. Rise to all 4s. Walk your knees up in between your hands. Okay, so your knees are in line with your wrists. And then you're going to sit down in between your ankle bones for Virasana. Okay? This is our seated hero pose. Knees together, ankle bones slightly apart. Okay, so it looks like this, kind of like a pizza slice. And if this isn't great for you, you can sit on a block or 2 blocks to get a little more height. Some of you will happily stay here. This will be deep. Others, you can recline to your elbows or all the way to your back. I think tailbone scoops towards kneecaps. That's the energetic motion. We'll be here for about 7 breaths. If you're up, you can even put your hands on the soles of your feet and just push down. That can feel really nice. You're beautiful. Last few breaths. One more big breath. Good. If you're reclined, slowly come on back up. Sit to the left of your heels. And then bring your right foot outside of your left thigh for seated spinal twist. This is Ardha Matsyendrasana. Right hand behind your back. And you can either hook your left elbow outside the right thigh or wrap the arm around, hug it in. Cool. Inhale, grow taller. And then exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, taller. Exhale, a little deeper of a twist. Look forward. And then counter the twist. Take both hands to your left. Just 1 breath cycle. Good. Back to center. Hands behind you. Switch your legs. The left foot outside the right thigh. Set it up, and if your hips are tight, you can extend your right leg, your bottom leg forward. Left hand down, right arm up, twist to the left. Inhale. And then exhale, twist to the left, a little deeper. Inhale, taller. Exhale, twist deeper. Two more breaths here. Good, look forward. Counter the twist, hands to your right. Just one breath cycle. Back to center. Okay, my very favorite pose. Well, I have a few. I love this one. Double pigeon. So your left leg is already outside your right thigh. You're gonna slide that bottom shin forward, and we're gonna stack left shin on right shin. You might need to adjust your hips. Your left ankle is just beside the right thigh as much as possible. And if you have a block, it's nice to use a block between ankle and knee. All right? This is a really deep one. You can stay right here or start to fold forward. Maybe elbows come to the ground and you can happily just be up here. Okay? This is our pigeon pose today. An alternate is to lay on your back and take figure four. All right? Just breathe, soften the eyes, and pay complete attention. Be one with this very moment. No separation. Last few breaths. Good. If you're leaning forward, walk your hands in. Take both hands to your left, one breath cycle. Back to center, to the other left. I believe the French call it the right. Back to center. Extend your legs, shake them out. Shake them, shake them, shake them. All right, change sides. Yeah, so your right shin on top, left shin on the bottom. We try to slide that bottom shin forward. So it usually starts kind of close in. Try to wiggle it forward. All 10 toes point in. Adjust the knee, adjust the hips. You can move the skin away from your sitting bones a little bit. Lift the heart with a flat back. If it's reasonable for you, start to bow forward. Breathe into it. Balancing effort and ease. So while you are working, while you're actually efforting in this pose, part of you is totally relaxed. Totally relaxed. Last five. Go deeper into it. Not in pain. Two more breaths. One more breath, but go a little deeper before you come out. And walk your hands in. Both hands to the right, one breath cycle. Back through center to the left. Back to center, reach the legs long, and shake them out. That feels good. Move the flesh away from your sitting bones, make some space. Reach the arms up, Paschimottanasana. Exhale, bow forward over your legs. You can hold your feet, great. If you can't, great. But you want the shoulders to be back. Okay, look up here for a second. So the shoulders are not like this. The shoulder blades are down. The heart leads. And that might mean your hands are right here. Or here. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, deepen your fold.
You can use a strap also, that's a nice tool.
Breathe for three. Against the long, hot, heavy summer. Two. One more big breath. Look forward.
Walk your hands up your legs. Bring the hands behind you. Bend the knees, place the feet on the floor for reverse tabletop. So it's a nice counter pose. Inhale. And then exhale, lift your hips up, push into the feet, fire up the glutes. Think tailbone towards your kneecaps. And then you can slowly let the head go back. And I like to make just little circles here. It feels really nourishing for my shoulders, my wrists. But take care of the hands, so grip the fingers. Always awake through the hands, through the points of foundation. Good, one more inhale. And exhale, come on back down. Let's lower to our back. What do you say? Right knee to your chest. Place the left foot on the floor. And just draw a few circles with that right ankle. Reach your right leg up to the sky. You can clasp the hands behind the thigh, the calf, or some of us might be able to hold the big toe. Okay, take what feels reasonable. Stay here, or you can go a little deeper by extending that left leg down. Breathe here for a moment. It's not about the pose. It's not about how deep you go or how much you stretch or sweat. It is all about the quality of your awareness. The quality of your awareness. Your ability to remain present. Even when the mind is saying, I'm hungry, I'm thirsty, I want to go on the internet, I want to check my email, I want to check social media. All that mind stuff. The advanced practitioner catches that mind and returns yet again, to right here. Good. Bend the right knee, draw it into your chest, give it a squeeze, then give it a little kiss. And then we take a twist. Right knee over to the left. You can look to the right. Five breaths. Good, back to center. Right foot to the floor. Left knee to your chest. Give it a squeeze. Roll the ankle. Point and flex the foot. And then reach the leg up. Flex through the toes. So we're not just pointing the toes and we're not just flexing the toes. Spread the toes and push through the ball of the foot. Okay, feel the difference? Stay here, reach the right leg long towards the ground. It might hover a little bit. You find the stretch that feels really juicy to you. Breathe for three, two. One more breath. Rebend your left knee, give it a little squeeze, and then twist. Left knee over to the right, left arm long to the left. Look over your left shoulder. Two more breaths. Breath here. Back to center. Left knee to your chest. Give it a kiss. Right knee to your chest. Give yourself a big hug. Big hug. Big hug. Feet to the floor. I'm going to give you two options for our final pose. Either Shavasana, the legs long, or the soles of the feet together as we began. Supta Baddha Konasana. Okay, so find your final posture.
If there are any other poses you absolutely need, you can take those. But I encourage you just to take rest right here. Take a final deep breath in. And a final breath out. Just a few minutes. I'll tell you when it's time to come out. Welcome home.
Tatana has a book up on the Calabo song of Bonga. Who wants a hand to say, I am
awaken your breath. Awaken your fingers and your toes. Stretch the arms over your head. Take a deep breath in. And a full breath out. One knee at a time towards your chest. Give yourself a squeeze. Then roll to the right, creating a pillow for yourself with your arm. Just pause. Think of the one you love. Just one. I know there's a few, but pick just one. And please repeat after me. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be free from harm and free from any suffering. May my life touch your life always for the better. May you love your life. Quietly press yourself back to a comfortable seat. Hands come to prayer at the heart. And we'll seal this practice with the eternal sound of Om. Deep breath in. Ah, Om. Carefully bowing forward with love, with devotion, with absolute gratitude for every breath and for every heartbeat, for every smile and for every tear, for every moment that I am awake and asleep. I bow humbly forward with gratitude. Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. Inhaling, we come up. And exhaling here. My friends and teachers, namaste. Om Bolo Shri Sadguru Bhagavan Ki Jai. Thank you all for being here, for sharing your practice. Can you give each other a round of applause, even though we can't hear it? Come on, give your neighbor some love. Hey, I'm so grateful for y'all. Thank you for being open to this. For some of you, it's probably a little bit different than what you're used to. So thanks for giving it a shot. I'll be here most Fridays at this time. And yeah, Adam's going to say a few words. So thank you all for being here.
Thank you, everyone. Just a quick announcement. Tomorrow, we have an awesome Ayurveda workshop. The subject is Ayurveda self-care and beauty routines. So we have this wonderful owner of an Ayurvedic spa in Los Angeles. She works with like all the celebrities, the Kardashians and all those people. So you can learn how Kim Kardashian treats her skin. Not that that's really relevant to anything here, but it's just,
I love Kim Kardashian. I want to come.
Coolest, right? We should all go.
Let's go.
But in all seriousness, she's a very wise individual and she, the subject, I personally have learned a lot from Ayurveda. Just how to care for the external parts of the body and how those same principles are then present inside of us as well. So this will
Did
be
you a talk lot. About like daily practices like tongue scraping and neti pot and
all that
Baya
stuff
and self massage and oil.
Oh, cool. It's actually going to be filmed right from their bathroom. They're just going to like take you through their bathroom and everything that they do in the Dinacharya every morning.
I love that.
Yep. So that's tomorrow at 1 p.m. Cool. And yeah, a bunch of other cool stuff happening this weekend. So just stay up to date with the schedule. But yeah, thank you everyone for practicing today. Thank you for being a part of this community. I feel the love growing. Like every day we show up here and it's like there's something new and awesome happening. So
yeah, it feels really good. And we're doing, if folks are interested in going deeper, I'm going to be part of the next teacher training that's beginning September 7th. So coming up, and what do we have, 5 or 10 more spots, Adam? It's getting full, right?
It's actually technically sold out. If anyone wanted to join, we could probably open up a couple more spots.
Okay. Well, I'd love to practice with you all and go a little deeper and kind of go behind the scenes of what it is to share the practice and really learn what is behind the chaturanga. What else is there in this yoga stuff? So if that interests you, reach out to either one of us and we'll get you on board. All right. Awesome. Thank you all for coming. I'm so grateful and I hope to see you very soon. All right. Get out of here. Bye. Thank you all. Bye, Valerie.